These are the subjects that are usually tougher than others, but if one has a good command on them, he or she can definitely secure a good rank in his or her school, state, or even in the country. See, these are the... So hey guys, welcome back to Rohan Channel with a very interesting continuation video of our subject-wise analysis and super tips. Some of you might be knowing that we uploaded the first part of this video in which we discussed the most important points for our first three board exams. But now, as you all requested, we are back with the second part of this video in which we will try our level best to brief you all with the most important points which you must follow in your coming board exams in order to score above 95% for sure. So without any delay, let's get started. The next subject is History and Civics. And the first thing that comes into our mind when we hear this subject is cramming. See, History Civics no doubt involves cramming, but it is only 40% of the exam's preparation. Rest 60% depends on your thorough knowledge of the subject. We generally prepare for this subject in a wrong manner. The most efficient preparation follows three steps. First is knowing your syllabus. What most of us do is that we start reading the chapter without knowing the syllabus, and by reading the whole chapter, we feel bored. What I want you is to first check the index which is present at the start of every chapter. And only those topics are asked in the exam. Rest of the topics are just for general understanding. For example, in the chapter of Assertive Nationalists, it is clearly written in the index that you have to remember their names and only two contributions of everyone. But we generally read the whole of the topic, and this is the main reason of boredom in History Civics preparation. Now that you know the syllabus, the second thing to do is to see your short and long answers of every chapter, and instead of cramming them, form your own answers on the basis of what you read in the chapter. In History and Civics paper, only points are checked. No one sees the wordings of your answer. The third and the most important thing to do is to make flow charts for every long answer. Flow chart is a simple type of diagram that represents whole of your answer in a single go. Some flow charts are also given in your book, but make sure you also add your flavor in them. If you don't know what flow charts are, you can search it on Google to get a perfect idea about that. Let me tell you that if in your board exams, you draw a clear flow chart for every long answer, trust me, the examiner will not look on the matter which you would have written below. The procedure for writing long answers is making a flow chart first and then explaining your points on the basis of that flow chart. In your flow charts, it is advised that you draw different shapes in order to make it attractive, but make sure it looks tidy and catchy. And if you follow these three steps, I guarantee your proficiency in this subject for sure. If we talk about the important chapters, I would like to tell you that its preparation is based upon the units. For example, history portion contains 5 units and civics portion includes 3 units, from which you can skip any one unit from each of the portions. Like the units in history include chapters 1 and 2 as one unit, chapter 3, 4, 5 another unit, chapter 6, 7, 8, 9, then chapters 10, 11, 12, and finally chapters 13, 14, and 15. So here, what you can do is that you can skip any one unit. For example, you can skip chapters 6, 7, 8, and 9. But make sure that if you skip any one unit, then you must have a solid command on the other 4. And also, chapter skipping is only valid for long answers. You will have to memorize the short answers of every chapter. Similar is the case with civics. The units are chapter 1, then chapter 2 and 3, and finally chapter 4 and 5. Here also, you can skip any one unit. If we talk about the checking, the examiner only checks your points in your answer with respect to the marks of the question. Another thing that increases your score in long answer writing is the use of flow charts. Flow charts make a solid impression upon your examiner that you have a deep knowledge of the subject. Moreover, flow charts are easier to remember rather than long scripted answers, because flow charts get stored in our visual memory and thus it is retained in our mind for far more duration. Now let's come on to our next subject, that is physics. So before I begin, I must tell you that usually the physics board exams paper is slightly tougher than the other two sciences, because physics is a subject which requires feel of the subject. So my first suggestion to you is to stop cramming physics. Once you understand any topic, you will never forget it. The other thing that you have to do is to give a little more stress on numericals of certain chapters and also some to-the-point questions which are usually asked in the exam. If we talk about the important chapters, there is nothing like important chapter in physics. All the chapters are important, it won't be wise to neglect any of them. However, greater focus must be given to mechanics, light and electricity unit. Physics paper checking is completely based upon your power of expressing the answers. More the clarity in your answer, more marks you will get. In this paper, the examiner only checks your thorough knowledge in your answers and also your command in that topic. So make sure you also include some examples in your answers wherever necessary. This gives a perfect impression on the checker. The next subject is chemistry. Now this is a subject which most of you might feel difficult, but it is not. Preparation for chemistry follows four simple steps. First, learning. Second, writing. Third, learning. Fourth, again writing. Chemistry involves a lot of memorizing power, and that will only come by learning and writing no matter what one says. Learning plus writing what you learned is the perfect match for a brilliant score. Give more stress on equations, one word questions and also the numericals of mole concept. These topics have a much higher weightage in the exam. The most important chapters for chemistry board exams are organic chemistry, mole concept, electrolysis, study of compounds and finally the very important aluminium portion in metallurgy. In this exam, the examiner usually checks your memorizing power and most important how many equations you write in your paper. So make sure that you write all the equations and that required answer wherever necessary. The next subject is Punjabi. For those who have taken any other languages except Punjabi, they can skip this portion and move on to the next subject, that is geography. See, Punjabi is a very scoring subject. You can easily get 97, 98, 99 or even 100 in this exam provided you follow these steps. First is writing long answers of minimum 8 lines. Second is including the important facts in your answer at first. Third is improving your neatness and handwriting in the paper. Fourth is improving your knowledge and vocabulary in your answer writing. And fifth is minimizing the grammatical mistakes or spelling mistakes which you make in your paper. And these are the only things which the examiner perceives in your paper. If he or she is able to find these points in your answers, there is no doubt that you will definitely get 100 on 100. The most important factor in your Punjabi paper is your handwriting and the first 2 to 3 lines of your answer. So make sure you strongly work on those points. The next subject is geography. See, geography is a way simpler subject if you prepare for it wisely. Geography preparation is also based on selection of units. There are total 9 units in your book and you have to do only 5 units, of course, of your choice. And the 9 units are Chapter 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, 10, 11 and 12, 13 and 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 and 19. Don't worry, you can take a screenshot of this. So these are the 9 units and you have the choice to do any 5. And the procedure for preparing that 5 units is based upon 3 steps. First is reading the chapter thoroughly. Second is solving the questions given on the back of the chapter. And the third and the most important step is to solve self-study portion in the chapters wherever it is provided. Now if you follow this, more than half of your preparation is completed. Now you have to give much stress on topography and maps because these two topics are your marks deciders. If you score well in them, you will get full marks. See, everyone has the ability to write lengthy answers in geography exam, but only few of them have a good command on topography and maps, and I want you all to be in that few ones category. And if we talk about paper checking, the examiner gives more focus on the map and topography portion of your paper. So make sure you write it correctly. And that would only be possible if you have deep knowledge about it. The next subject is computer applications. For those who haven't chosen this subject, they can skip to the next subject, that is biology. Now see, computer applications is completely based upon understanding of basics. If you have your basics clear, you have to just revise and refine them. Also give more focus on program building. They have a much higher weightage in exam and they are obviously the marks deciders. Make sure you construct variable description tables after every program. And trust me, if you construct variable description table in your board's paper, your 5 marks are confirmed in every program you write. Basically, there are 6 types of programs asked in your computer paper. These are railway ticket or electricity bill type program, string type program, function overloading type, special number type, looping type, and most important, array type. Now, the things which the examiner checks in section A of the paper is your ability to give to the point correct answers. In section B, the checker usually checks your structure of the program, VD table, and the errors that you made in your program. Make sure you work on them and also include comments in your program if you have extra time at the last. The important topics in computer include difference between constructors and functions, parameterized and non-parameterized constructor, variables and constant, primitive and composite data type, entry and exit control loop, if and switch statements, linear and binary search, scanner and buffer class formats, string and match functions like seal and floor function, and the most important advantages of array. The next and the last subject is biology. If we talk about this subject, even I agree that biology requires a lot of cramming. So the first and the prioritized thing which you must do is practice, and only practice of this subject as much as you can. Even the examiner looks for the technical terms that you write in your answers. So make sure you give more stress on technical terms given in each and every chapter. And believe me, once you learn the habit of answering your questions with technical terms included, you will definitely get a 100 on 100 in this very subject. The main point is to find interest in this subject. The important chapters for this subject are, of course, genetics, absorption by roots, photosynthesis, and most important, the organ systems. Now let's come on to the most suspenseful part of this video. That is the name of the rank decider subjects and also the most scoring subjects in ICSE board exams. So before I tell you their names, you must understand the meaning of rank decider subjects. These are the subjects that are usually tougher than others, but if one has a good command on them, he or she can definitely secure a good rank in his or her school, state, or even in the country. See, these are the subjects which not everyone is good at. And according to me, those subjects are English language, physics, and chemistry. Now let's come on to the top scoring subjects for board exams. These are the subjects where you can get 100 on 100 far easier than other subjects. And according to me, those subjects are maths, English literature, Punjabi, computer applications, or physical education. So with this, we end up our detailed video on ICSE Class 10 board exams. Make sure you share this video ahead and subscribe to our channel for more such informative and rank booster videos in the near future. Also comment the next video topic which you want from my side. But I guarantee from my side in writing that if you follow these very steps in each and every subject, no one can prevent you to score even above 96% in your Class 10 board exams. There is still too much time left for your board exams. Nothing is lost. I will meet you soon on a very fresh video based upon your comments. Till then, stay happy, stay fit, all the very best, strive hard to achieve big. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram.